It's alive. It's alive. It's alive. It's alive.
Welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to do something outside the big box. As I like to say, what we're going to do is we're going to go over definitely the Mongoose Blackcomb, how I liked it, how it did, and everything. If this is where, if you didn't see the ride videos or you couldn't hear me, because I'm sorry, I did have the volume wasn't the greatest. I made a mistake on that, but that's another story. User error by myself. Gonna talk about the bike, how I liked it, things that's going on with it, what I wanna do. And then also, we're gonna do my second favorite thing after new bike day, is new parts day. Yay, so new parts day coming up, one of my favorite days to have. I love new parts day. I love new bike day. I love new parts day. I love riding. I love riding new trails. Three favorite things. Sometimes the order diversifies, right? So sometimes one can be three, two could be one, and so on. Anyway, all right, so along to the Mongoose Blackcomb. So it really did a good job. It's got a zoom for it. I measure from the bottom and out, you know, and which I didn't hear a lot of when I was riding, and I took it on some rough stuff, you know, not the roughest stuff there could be, but lots of roots. We did some jumps with it. It held up good. I mean, I really enjoyed riding this bike. So we got 80 millimeters of travel here, front fork. It is a straight steer, but we can find a good fork for that. 6 inches eye to eye on the rear shock. It's a 3x8 for 24 speeds. Very capable bike. The seat tube itself is 32 millimeters, so it's good quality seat post. I do not, and this is the one thing that I don't look, two things that I don't like, but that's a normal thing not to like. These are normal. Don't mind the grip. Trips are fine. Lock on. I don't like the handlebars. Straight steer. I'm probably going to shorten this up. I'm definitely going to shorten that up because I'm sitting too far like this. Yeah, I don't like riding like that. I like more of a... It's bad for my back. I got a lot of back stuff going on. We'll discuss that. It is a 19-inch frame. It's a large frame. It does have 26-inch wheels. Now, 26-inch wheels, right, you don't have that, the confidence of 29ers rolling over everything. You don't roll over as much. At first, it was a bit sketchy to me, or for me, because I'm used to riding the swim boundary with 29-inch rims on, I mean, wheels on there. So I've gotten used to that rollover. So at first, it took a little bit. It just felt like I wasn't gonna make it over things because, you know, the size difference. So I do understand why they came out with 27.5. It gives you versatility, you know, the best of both worlds. It gives you the versatility of the 26 being quick and nimble, and it gives you some rollover power like the 29s. So I understand the 27.5. But first thing we're gonna change, definitely the handlebars have to go. Need some upswing, some rise to it. And these pedals. I had lots of slips on the pedals, but that's something that I wasn't expecting these to be great top of line pedals out the box. That's about it. I had some issues. Well, it's not really the, I'm going to say it's not even the Shimano Altus. I got an issue with second and third. Hold on. Okay. I'll show you guys if I can. Not a big thing. This is something I need to fix on adjustment with the way. A couple of turns is not bad. I fix. So nothing big. And like I said, I rolled it straight out the box. I am getting a little bit of brake rub back there. I take through a lot. Another thing that I can also let you guys know to adjust the brakes. I did a
little thing on brakes itself, but to adjust the brakes, and what this problem is, as you can hear, I should have went the other way. So you hear it's just a little ever so slight rub. I don't know if you guys can see this, I'm trying to get in there, but usually, so where your brake is connected, sometimes you get just a little bit of play like this. You see how my fingers is being stopped right there? I'm willing to bet. I'm not a gambling man though, but I would bet at least $2.50, maybe five, that if I loosen this up, push that over a little bit, that should solve that problem. So hey, you know what? Hey, let's give it a try. See. Can I get a right guess? Just loosen that. I'm gonna push in on it. Then tighten it back. Let's see if we get now. It should resolve. So it really sometimes. Can't say all the time. Sometimes it's really simple things to adjust things. So here we go. Now, simple as that, that brake is not squeaking, doesn't need any oil, it's good. So little things like that. Overall, very capable bike. I really, really, really enjoy riding the bike. I'm gonna try to make this as budget friendly as a build as possible, right? So I'm gonna try to make it so not breaking the bank, and making it so, like I said, it's something that's cost effective for everybody. If this is a way that someone decided to go, the route someone decided to choose to go. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna do upgrades, but I'm not gonna do it as like I did with the swing. On the boundary, I went pretty much all out. You know, I got SLX, hydraulic brakes, SLX derailleur, an 11 to 46 tooth in the rear, so it's 1x11, carbon fiber handlebars. We just went all out, you know, remote lockout on the maybe 120, not sure, or it's 120 and I can
make it 140. That's what I think it is. Yes, that's the correct answer. It's 120, and I can make it 140. I can't remember. I may have already made 140. I can't remember. I started doing so many projects on these bikes that I get all turned around. Kai's bike is done too. MTB Kid Kai. I gave him the Pro Rush 7-speed off of the Swim Boundary. Let you guys take a look at that too. He's looking clean. Yeah. He's looking clean. Look at him. Clean. Mm-hmm. I think this is a 14 to, I don't know if it says it on here. The gear that I'm in is right on it. Yeah, he's at a 14 to 38 too. So he's gonna be doing some mad climb. He's gonna be doing really well with this. I think this is really gonna help him. So this is a budget-friendly upgrade for how you do your kids' bike, right? You take something off your bike, upgrade your bike, and then if you can, put it on your kids' bike. That'll help them out and save you some money, definitely. Right, I think this bike is extremely capable. I love and I enjoy riding this bike. I'm gonna ride this bike a lot, I know I am. But instead of me putting that $400, or we say $300, into this bike, I'm gonna put that $300 into my entry-level full assist that I'm gonna be purchasing soon after this, to have a complete bike that comes, and I'm sure I'm still gonna do upgrades to that, right? Still entry level is always upgrades to be done, so I'll still upgrade that. But hey, let's get to my favorite part of the video. We stopped talking so much, apologize about that. I'll get to my favorite part of the video, and that's right, parts day. Yep, I've already started ordering parts, so we'll start upgrading very soon. Some have come. I think the rest of them will be here tomorrow and Monday, no, Tuesday, something of that nature. So let's see what we've gotten so far. And the kids took the Liberty, MTB Kid Kai, and daughter Talia took the Liberty to open up some of my packages today. Wasn't their fault, technically. It was some kind of mistake happened. My wife ordered some things from Amazon for the kids. And for some strange reason, her stuff came in today for my daughter. My stuff was coming in today. And somehow, my stuff, which is strange, has her name on it. So, guess it wasn't that bad. Oh, even though they did open it already for me. Yeah. That's what we were talking about. So we got some new pedals. Usually I like these Misera pedals. I have them both on the Swim aluminum comp and the Boundary. I like these. They work good with my big foot, so comfortable. I like them. But I was like, let me think outside the big box. Here's the ones for on the Swim, same. Well, they're not exactly the same, but yeah, similar. Yeah, pretty much. On the Swim Boundary, and I like these, but I wouldn't step outside the big box, right? As I always say, right? That's my new saying, and I'm sticking to it. And I hadn't tried any other pedals besides the factory pedals, so I said, well, I know you're a loyal guy, Mike, but that's a bit biased also. So I had to give somebody else a chance. And I said, well, let me try some other pedals and see how those pedals are and how I like them. So Pure Aroma. All right, so they are made in China. Let's see what we have here. I don't open stuff neatly. I'm not want to rip it open. So we're gonna test these pedals out. See how they went. So here they are. Actually, it's a nice pedal. I like the different design. So actually you have the three here, one here, right? But you also have three on this back side, so when it does flip over, it's the same location and spacing. Which I like. I mean, it seems like a nice pedal. See, size wise, looking like the same size. Oh, they are. I really like these. Let me show you guys that. I'm sorry about that. So they are the same size as the Misery pedals. So I think I'm gonna like these. We'll definitely give them a shot. I don't know if this will be a little lighter. I don't know. But we'll see how they work out. So, all right, got those. Got some extra spikes coming along with it. Next thing we have here. What is this box? So I guess I got a pedal. Alright, what's in here? They've already opened. Oh yeah, that's something I was gonna change out too. But I'm gonna change out the brakes. And here are the brakes. Alright. New brakes. I think these are Zoom brakes. Yes, these are Zoom brakes. So we do have that Zoom fork on there, which I'm going to be taking off. But these are Zoom hydraulic brakes. Hydraulic disc brakes. So I'm going to be putting it on there. You see the red matches with the red on the pedal. So that's going to be awesome. And then, of course, we got some Zoom nice, right? I like them. Seat, like these seats. They're nice, like these seats. As you see, I got the model going to be red. We got seats and what is this? Feels like a stem. Is stem, hydraulic brakes, red rotors, and some Paroma red pedals. I like this so far. All right, that's how I feel about the Mongoose Blackcomb. Hope everyone enjoyed the content. Please like, video, subscribe to the channel,
And definitely make sure you got the notifications turned on. All right, everybody, have a blessed day. Hasta luego, so we can dirt you. Deuces. Bow wow. I'm out. I love this bike.